We started about 4 or 5 years ago, and it took about, I think, 26 months. And to train about a few weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. First we had a kind of training in Leipzig, driving on the streets, jumping over some hills, or I don't know, kind of that. And well, later we had, or here in Huntsville, we had kind of conditional training, running, stretching, all this. Yes, we had to pack the moon buggy in our baggage. So we took about 6 baggages on the plane to put it here together in Huntsville. Yeah, we are happy, we're glad to be here to follow our forefathers. Yes.
All right, we're here at the start line, and the safety check's going on here. This is our team from Germany. They've been here several years, and they kind of don't want me to interfere while they're giving their safety check, so I'm going to stand back a little bit and let you take a look at their buggy. They're pretty experienced here for a high school team, and I know that they've done a lot of work on this buggy. I think they're finished now, so I can talk to you. What's your name?
Hello, my name is Steffi. I'm from Germany.
And tell me about your buggy.
Well, our buggy has the colors of the German flag, red, yellow, and black. And we had to transport it in our baggage to bring it from Germany to here in about 7 baggages. And yes, the last few days we made some training. And for example, we did some speed record of 80 miles per hour.
Started as 80 miles per hour. Wow, I'm going to get this on the 565 out there, but 50 miles, that's incredibly fast. What's your name?
My name is Stefan Martini. I'm from Munich. And yeah.
Is this the first time for you racing?
No, I've already been here in the first year, 2007. And yes, we made a good job, and now we want to be better than the last year's.
Yeah, last year, what, about 6th place, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
And that was a big improvement. So you guys have worked really hard, you've trained really hard, and I know you're ready to get up to that start line, so we're going to let you go and settle in and get ready to take a bumpy ride across this course.
All right, thanks, Lori. Looks like the International Space Education Institute is about ready to go here. Now, Frank, I don't know if you can see on their buggy there, it actually looks like they've got an upturned umbrella.
Well, that's the high-gain antenna. Every moon buggy has to have a simulated, doesn't have to be operational, high-gain antenna. There are 7 items they have to carry with them.
And that's one of the 7?
That's one of the 7. There's a high-gain antenna, low-gain antenna, TV camera, radio, flag, and some controls, just like replicating what was on the lunar rover.
And of course, they're simulated.
There are.
So obviously, that's not an actual antenna, which would be impressive. But if I'm not mistaken, the German team actually has put a real onboard camera their buggy, and they're going to be recording it to their computers, and they're going to see if that may help them tweak their future designs.
And you know, our judges look for all those items at the start line. And when they finish the race, if any of them are gone, they get a penalty for dropping them on the course.
Oh, no. Well, there they go, hitting that first obstacle, got over it just fine. In 2009, last year, they actually finished in 6th place with a runtime of 4 minutes and 27 seconds. And as it was in 2008, the year before, they also finished in 6th place, but their time was 10 minutes and 12 seconds.
Yes, and that's
that's
a more common time, but they're not going to win the race with that.
And I think that's more of a problem with penalties. But it looks like they're cruising along so far. It looks like they haven't dropped that antenna.
That's right.
Or any of their cameras. They're rolling down, coming down our Rocket Park area here. Oof, bounced off, got a little wobbly on that last obstacle. There they are making that turn there, that 90 degree.
Now they're doing very well, Bill.
Yeah, that about back there on that along that stretch there is where the Saturn V rocket that is currently in the Davidson Center here used to reside.
You know, that's the fact that they're able to get over these obstacles is really a credit to the design that they've used.
And they've got a little bit of experience with this as well. In fact, they in 2007 was their rookie year. They finished with a total time of 7 minutes and 13 seconds. So actually did really well the first time. than the they had a little bit of trouble in 2008. So here they are coming down the outside of the crater before they're about to go into it.
This is where that clearance under the buggy is so important.
Because you can't exactly take one at a full hop.
Deepest crater, I think, in there has a rim that's about 15 inches above the surface.
So you're either going to have to clear it in the air, which you don't exactly want to go airborne too much in these.
It's a pretty tight turn, so they're not going very fast in this crater.
Let's see, they took best rookie team in 2007, and actually last year they took, I hope they didn't drop something. They both looked over as if they had, maybe they were just making sure that they cleared their cones there. Last year they took the home the most improved prize, of course, for shaving nearly 6 minutes off their time.
Well, and along. They're doing really well.
Yeah, look at them go. They train hard for this. Then they're actually we've gotten lots of video and even some newspaper clips from their advisor, who has shown us that they're actually getting to be pretty well known over in Germany.
Yep. And they are the team that has done more propaganda, spreading the word in Europe for us than anybody else. And I think we can expect Russian teams next year.
Well, let's flip around here quickly. We just missed the German team cross the finish line. Let's run right over here quickly and see what the condition of the track was and what the condition of the riders are. How'd it go?
Hello.
We'll give you a minute, or not really a minute. We'll give you 2 seconds. Okay, now how was it?
It was great. We had a good run.
I understand. I think she's not as out of breath as you are. You must have been doing all the work. No, I'm kidding. Tell me how you're feeling.
Well, I'm out of breath. It was so awesome. Wow.
Is it worth it to come all this way to put your buggy parts in your suitcase and then put it all together when you get here and then to do this? What makes that worth it?
It's worth because you get to know each other, like other countries, like you, for example. And
it's just fun. I'm going to let you catch your breath, but good job. You guys, that's going to be a pretty fast time, looks like to me. Let's go back over here to the start line now.
Would you please tell me your name and spell it for me?
Okay, Stephanie Fleischer, Stephanie Fleischer.
Okay, and what year are you in school?
My school is the Karl Orff Gymnasia in Unterschleißheim in Bavaria.
Say that again, I'm sorry.
In Bavaria, okay. Karl Orff Gymnasia.
Okay. How did you come up with the design for your moon buggy?
We had kind of papers for painting for the little boys and girls in the Space Education Center in Leipzig. And, well, they were painting all the time, and we chose one.
Wow. So how long did it take you to build and test it?
I don't know, because we started about 4 or 5 years ago, and it took about, I think, 26 months. And to train about a few weeks, 2-3 weeks, not more.
So training, you guys did some real physical training. So tell me a little bit about your training. What did you have to do to physically train in preparation for this event?
First we had a kind of training in Leipzig, driving on the streets, jumping over some hills, or I don't know, kind of that. And well, later we had, or here in Huntsville, we had kind of conditional training, running, stretching, all this. Yes, it's all.
Okay, excellent. What were the biggest challenges your team faced as you prepared for the race?
Oh, I don't know. What's your idea? No, I don't know.
Okay, no big technical challenges.
Yeah. No.
Yes.
Ach so, okay, yes. I'm sorry. Yes, we had to pack the moon buggy in our baggage. So we took about 6 baggages on the plane to put it here together in Huntsville.
Okay. That is very challenging and expensive. Any interesting stories from your, was an interesting story, but do you have any additional ones that you want to share with us from your preparations? Getting ready for the trip?
Not really, I think. No.
Okay. Is there anything you want
Good question. Yeah, we are happy, we're glad to be here to, to follow our forefathers. Yes.
All right, well, thank you so much and good luck.
Yeah, thank you too.
Okay.
Bye.